So hi, my name is Greg Kaduchak. I'm a principal scientist at Thermo Fisher Scientific. I've spent more than 30 years in the fields of light scatter, microfluidics, detection, and ultrasound. Last two decades of my career have been predominantly dedicated to flow cytometry. Here at Thermo Fisher Scientific, I've had the pleasure to lead the development of the Attune line of conventional flow cytometry instruments over the past decade. Flow cytometry consists of a bunch of single particles zooming past a laser. For each of these particles, we ask several questions in a flow cytometer. In the CytPix instrument, it's up to 16 questions. So what we might do is conjugate an antibody to a fluorophore and measure the fluorescence to see if that antigen is present. We may ask a functional question about a membrane or something internal to the cell. And that's what makes flow cytometry unique, is that we ask the question of single cells as opposed to many cells in aggregate. When you get the data, it's plotted in a multidimensional space. As I said, you know, we have 16 questions or 16 parameters in the CytPix. That would be a 16-dimensional space. And the data ends up being a dot in that space. You actually do not see the cell. So one of the questions, one of the challenges is, you know, can we discern a little bit more information about that cell? And that's really what the CytPix instrument is here for. Well, we've added brightfield high-resolution imaging to a conventional flow cytometer. To see what that particle looks like in correlation to the data. Is the sample good? Is it the cell I expect? Is there contamination or debris? Are the cells touching each other and communicating? I think when you're looking for that one in 10,000, one in a million cells, it would be good to be able to corroborate with some morphological information. We wanted to keep the CytPix first and foremost a conventional flow cytometer that customers are used to. I think it's a bit of nuance, but it says a lot. The design concept is that the user should not have to change anything in order to get some good high-resolution images of their cells. As a matter of fact, the imaging should be transparent in the background to a standard flow cytometry user. It's a difficult problem to image many small particles moving at high speed. I think in typical flow cytometers, especially this one, you're looking at about small particles going at about 25 feet per second. In time frames on the order of tens of nanoseconds. That's in comparison to what you would see on a typical microscope, which is orders of magnitude longer time frame, where they operate in tens to hundreds of milliseconds. So we've had to develop the imaging systems, but also the electronics. We've had to develop a lot of electronics for timing and processing the data in those timescales and to build in the checks and balances to make sure everything is correlated. It is a conventional flow cytometer that can take very good high resolution images of your cells of interest. When using it, a customer would find really no difference between operating it in a conventional flow cytometer. I think in addition, we made it such that you do not have to image everything and create huge storage problems. You get high resolution of cells of interest and just take a few pictures for archival purposes. Maybe you only want to image a specific population of cells. Maybe you just want to take standard conventional flow data with no images. We've left it up to the customer to decide how much data they need and how much they want to generate without changing their current protocols. Wow, that's really cool. I think the first time you see the images associated with the dots, it's impressive. Many instances, even in our own internal testing, we found instances of contamination within the sample. I mean, we've seen contamination of bacteria, fungi, yeast, and cell cultures. I think really having that peace of mind to know your sample and how it's related to the data, I think, is very important. The imaging data is a big addition, I think, to the conventional flow cytometry data. We are just launching the system now, but scientists are already starting to come up with interesting ways, to use this new data. I think walking by just the other day, I was doing an experiment, and there was a scientist walking behind me, and he's like, "Help! There's an activated T cell." He was able to discern that just through, looking at the morphological data. So I think it's going to be very interesting to be able to correlate these types of things with those dots, as I was saying before. So in general, I think there's going to be a lot of new interesting discoveries within flow cytometry. Once this image data is correlated with flow cytometry data, on this type of scale.